An upstate Tea Party believes it's being targeted by the IRS because of its political views. News 4's Mike McCormick is in Lawrence with the Tea Party's president, who's asking for justice from Congress.
All of our activities.
Diane Belsom is holding stacks of proof from the back and forth she's had with the IRS.
It seemed unreasonable.
Belsom is the president of the Lawrence County Tea Party, which filed paperwork with the IRS in 2010 to be tax exempt. The filing fee was $400.
We really have no money to start with, but we paid the $400.
Paying up hadn't paid off a year later.
I called them and they said, well, your case is still pending. I said, okay, well, I guess we don't need to do anything then, right? And he's like, oh, no, you have to still file a tax return.
Right before the 2012 election, she got a detailed letter asking for all kinds of documentation. In January of 2013, she got asked for even more information, like copies of posts in their private Facebook group.
And I'm like, well, people who've commented in here are under the impression this is confidential, so I had to go with a black marker and cross out everybody's names to protect them.
Still, after all that, nearly 3 years after initially filing, the Lawrence County Tea Party hasn't gotten an answer from the IRS.
Regardless of what your political views are on the Tea Party or anything else, this should bother you that our government is targeting a group of people based on their political beliefs.
Belsom believes the drawn-out process was meant to distract the Tea Parties from campaigning for their candidates during the election.
I think this did have a chilling effect on the groups and possibly did impact the elections.
And she says the activist organization Freedom Works is actually bringing her to Washington, D.C. tonight to speak about this IRS issue over the next few days. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4 in Lawrence.